All stations, all stations.
Mumbai Control, how do you read? All stations, Mumbai Control, how do you read?
Loud and clear, Victor Tango, Juliet Sierra Bravo.
Radio 5, Victor Tango, Mike India Echo.
Radio 5.
Radio 5, Victor Tango, Alpha Bravo Hotel.
How about others? How about others? Guys, can I just see all? Can I see the class? Nice to see you, Jeet. Nice to see you, Harshad. Mukul, nice to see you. Abhipriti, nice to see you. Dwij, very nice of you to join today. Nice to see you. Sudhanshu, hello. Very nice to see you. And Anshul, I think you're still connecting. Okay, so one by one, in the sequence of how I have seen you and acknowledged, just give me a update on what did you do after the first and the second lecture of navigation? Did you revise? Did you go through your own notes that you made? What's your stat? It might seem that it's too soon to ask because you have just studied a little bit, but I want to know what you have done in short and brief. Or if you have not done anything, you can say, sir, I just attended the class. I have not done anything else. Even that is okay. I just need to know an update from you one by one, starting with Jeet.
I just went through the videos of the lecture and revised my notes. And I guess I can say I'm pretty good with this chapter right now.
Very good. Harshit, your turn.
Sir, I missed the first part of navigation bash, so I revised that and through videos I revised the second part also.
Very good. So you have attended the first session that you have missed, right? Okay, I cannot hear you. I hope that's what it means. Next. I think it's Mukul.
I've revised the previous lecture as well as tried to explore the items which was done in the first lecture in detail, a little bit about.
Okay, very good. Dwij, I think you're attending for the first time. Have you gone through the recordings, first and second lecture? You're on mute, Dwij. You'll have to unmute yourself.
This is my first lecture, sir.
No problem. I have sent recordings to you for class 1 and class 2. Today, attend those recordings. We have done simple topics in detail. And whatever doubts you have, you tell me about those doubts. It will really be helpful for you. Although every session is like an individual topic only, but first and second lectures are actually connected. They are very easy. You can increase the playback speed to 1.5 or 1.25 and get it done in a faster pace. Attend that and give me a feedback once you have attended all the two lectures.
Okay.
try to make time. Okay, I know there are it is difficult to get a new schedule from your earlier schedule when you start something, but you have to keep your time aside for your aviation studies. Okay, you have to make it a habit no matter how busy you are. So I hope you will do it soon. Slowly you will pick up and you'll be able to do it. Okay, so thank you. Sudarshan. Yeah, Sudarshan, update. You're on mute.
Yes, sir. So I went through both of the recordings. I think I need a little bit more practice on that till I'm good in it.
Okay. Do you have any doubts? Why do you think you need more practice?
Sir, because actually in last recording, I couldn't able to attend the last class. So I just went through the recording. I didn't make any notes. So maybe I need a little bit more practice on that. So.
Okay. Okay. So go through it. Understand it. The topic is less. What we have covered is less, nothing else. So it will not be difficult. We have spoken about a lot of things that, you know, you can just listen and understand. And that understanding is very important, you know. I want you all to understand concepts. Memorizing will happen slowly and steadily over the period of time. So that is why, that is what I want, that you should understand everything that is told to you. That is very important. Okay, understanding is very important. So do that and thank you. Who's left? Abhipreeti, please tell me. Give me an update.
Yes, sir. I memorized all the 13 items of the ICAO flight plan, and I memorized all the definitions which you taught in the yesterday's.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Pavani, please give us an update of what you have done in terms of your free time about the two sessions that we have done, in terms of revisions, if you have done any or if you have not.
Yes, sir. The videos which you have updated in the YouTube, it helped me so much, which I missed during the signal was not good. Have seen it and I got updated the new things which I missed.
Okay, very good. Nice of you to do it, cover your tracks. It is very good to revise, you know. Okay, thank you for your update. Anshul, Sachin, what is an update from your side? So Anshul, I cannot see your mic is connected. So please fix that and get back to us. Sachin, have you been revising? Have you been going through the recordings, doing revisions based upon the notes? You're on mute, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes to what? Did you revise or did you just attend the lectures or are you still going to attend the lectures? What is the case?
I'm attending the two classes, sir. I had seen a YouTube also, sir.
Okay, very good. Very nice.
One class missed, sir, yesterday, 7 o'clock.
That was RT class. That recording email has also been sent to you. Attend that
yes,
today.
Sir.
For today's session, attend that.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay, good. Good to see, guys. This is a good habit. Understand this is just our first week and we are going slow, steady, getting to, you know, understand the pace and, you know, develop a good base. And as we go ahead, we will be, you know, striking out all the important topics first and we'll increase the length of our sessions whenever we are having lectures. I'll give you enough time in between to not make you get tired with the continuous sessions. So I'll include some human factors also in that. So you need to use that time to revise and rest both, okay? And we will be revising the time of our sessions in future so that we get more time to study. So maybe you'll be required to get up early sometimes in the morning for a week or two, or maybe stay back a little late at night. Whatever it is, as required, I'll be asking you all to do it with me. So be prepared mentally. The exams might happen in July, or October. The July session can be pushed forward to August, but I just checked the tentative examination schedule and I saw that the regular exams happen in July and then October. Okay, so 15th June, some relaxations will be given. But considering how CBSE exams have been cancelled, I think all education institutes will take it safe. They must have been instructed that postponed exams, cancel exams, and just take it easy to care about the students, which is a good thing. So the same will happen with you guys also. So from that point of view, it will still be good enough for us to keep a target of July for our examinations. Although it will be too quick, but if we keep that target, then our preparation would be good. Okay. So you all also keep that in mind, whoever has applied for the computer number and is ready to fill the forms for the examination. Y'all be ready for that in your mind. And whoever is also joining me for regulations and metrology, we'll cover that also. You will have to attend more sessions with me. I'll try to keep it in a way wherein, you know, we can alternately stack it. We don't have to do all three lectures in the same day, but only two subjects in the same day alternately stacked. So that being said, mentally prepare yourselves that our official training has started and we will stay in sync. The best part is that you'll get to have a live session with me and the exact lecture recording also will be shared with you for revisions. So you don't have to worry about missing something, but that should not make you lazy thinking, oh, I'll not attend the class today. I'll just go through the recording. Please attend the live sessions also. Okay. There are times when, you know, recordings take some time to get uploaded. So you cannot just wait. But what do I mean by that? So today's lecture 3 and say tomorrow's lecture 4 and the recording of lecture 3 might not be uploaded until tomorrow night. So if you wait for the recordings, then you will miss lecture 3 and you will not, you will join lecture 4 and you will think you have missed something because you were not there in lecture 3. Although I try to make every lecture independent, but still somewhere or the other information will be skipped, which you will feel that, okay, maybe I don't know something from lecture 4 because I missed lecture 3. Okay. So try to attend unless it's a very important reason why you cannot attend. Your attendance has to be above 80 or 90%. All right. And I really value discipline and attendance. So please do it. And whenever you cannot, you have to tell me and you have to go through the recordings. You can tell me, sir, can you do something about the recordings? I need it before the next session and I'll try my best to do it for you personally also. For a few days, I'm keeping the recordings open on the channel, the playlist for you guys. Then I'll lock it only for you all to have an access to it. Okay. So, but let's see. Still, we are filtering people in the batch. I had registrations for a lot of people, but only half of them are attending. In a few days' time, I'll get to know who's serious and who's not, and who's regular and not. Only those people will be a part of this batch then. We'll not introduce more people afterwards, after a couple of weeks. Okay? Still, you know, there are two students that are missing who are regular students, and I don't like that. But it's okay. There's only so much that we can do. But if you attend sessions, everything else I'll take care of about your exams. But if you miss sessions, then I cannot do much. So remember that. And I'm very happy to see you all on a regular basis. It's a hat trick. Three lectures, 3 days, everyone who's attended the new session, revised sessions. Good job done. And yeah, if you have any questions or suggestions, please ask, or we'll start with our agenda for today. Now is your time to speak.
Sir, I want timetable, sir. Classes timetable.
Sachin, we have not yet devised a weekly timetable, so I cannot share with you. We are going spontaneously one day at a time and only planning for the next day. Once weekly timetables are scheduled, probably by next week or maybe end of next week, I'll share it with everyone.
Okay, sir.
So anything about tomorrow will be notified to you today only. It will be like okay, that. So far, we are going with that. Speak up, guys. Share something. Don't be silent.
So,
Go ahead.
So, when are you gonna start a revision test?
Yeah, Bhavani, I know you're excited for the test, but okay. I think I'll give you all one more day because I've not yet shared the notes with you all. So the test that was supposed to happen today, we will not take it today. So I'm not discussing it, but don't be disappointed. Be better prepared. I'll try to share the notes with you all tonight. The day you get notes, the next day you will have tests. So when I share the notes via email, I'll also inform about the test.
Yes, okay?
Yeah. Okay, thanks for reminding. I would have missed it. So nobody else remembers the test or you're just avoiding the test? What's happening, other guys? Jeet, Mukul, Harshit?
I'm prepared for it.
Okay, good. I wanted to take it, but it'll happen. We will, you know, notes and everything will become instantaneous quickly. Just a couple of days or some time more that I need. Okay, good. Okay, let's do one thing, okay? Let's just do something like a test. You all have a notebook and a pen, right? So just write this down. And we'll do it quickly. So, Dwij, although you have not attended much, just be a part of the team and just observe and learn, all right? And don't worry about anything. If you think everything is going over the top of your head, let it go. Just absorb as much as you can, okay? Once you go through lecture one and two, you'll understand everything.
Okay, okay. So,
yeah, just attend, don't run away. And yeah, Sachin, same for you. If you missed a session, don't worry. Whatever you can recollect, great. So yeah, let's do this. So what we are going to do is, I'm going to divide the class into teams. Okay. And one team will have to, you know, frame questions and ask the other team. And the other team will do the same with one team. If the question repeats, you will have to quickly change the question. All right. Now, how will it work? I'll show you and I'll divide you all into teams. One will be Team Air India and another will be Team Indigo. Okay. So in Air India, just write down your member names. Okay. In Team Air India, we have Dwij, we have Jeet. Sachin, you are in Team Indigo. Jeet, you are in Air India. Mukul, you are in Indigo. Abhipreeti, you are in Indigo. Pavani, you are in Air India. Sudhanshu, you are in Air India. And Harshit, you are in Indigo. And Anshul, I want you to be a part of Air India. Okay. I still cannot see your mic connected, so I'm not sure if you're live, but if you are, then you are with Air India. Okay. So every student will make one question and keep a second question also ready in case your first question is repeated. You can quickly go back to the second question. Your question will only be related to flight plan that we have studied so far and anything discussed in the sessions. So I'm giving you all 5 minutes to frame those two questions. Those questions should be along with options. Option A, option B, option C. And you'll give the options to the other class and any one student out of the batch will answer. And how will it work? So Team Air India, just tell me your member names one by one.
Jeet.
Dwij. Jeet. And?
Because I can go PayPal for Romeo, it's Pavanish.
Sir Sudhanshu.
And we have Anshul, right? Okay, and Indigo, we have Sachin, correct? And then we have Mukul. Then Harshit, you are in Indigo, right?
Yes, sir.
Then we have Abhipriti. And am I missing anyone?
Sachin.
Sachin written, first name. Good. Good. Okay. So, Jeet, although Dwij might not remember anything to make questions, so, but otherwise, Anshul is also not there, correct? He is there, he's not there, I don't know. So, Jeet, two questions. Pavni, two questions. Sudhanshu, two questions. Dwij, if you can make any question, please make any question. If not, just write down what others are saying. So start writing your questions. Whatever question you write, it should have three options, A, B, C. Okay? And remember to send me a picture or a WhatsApp of your questions later. All right? So I want to see you all right. And the same goes with Sachin. Sachin, if you can make a question or two, if you have attended a couple of sessions, good. Make two questions with options. One should be a correct option. Mukul, two questions. Harshit, two questions. Abhipriti, two questions. All right. From where I see, Team 6E will have more questions. That is Indigo. Air India will have lesser questions. But it is okay. We will see. Pavni, Sudhanshu, and Jeet, you can just make one extra question and keep it ready. So three questions in total. It could be anything, guys. You are free to make your own question and your options. One option should be correct out of three, okay? Don't put three incorrect options and make it very difficult for the other one to answer. Once your questions are made, I'll tell you all the rules and we'll quickly get it done in 5 to 10 minutes, all right? So your time starts now. One by one, once you're done writing those two questions and write them properly, okay? Write quiz lecture 3 and write those questions with options and underline the correct option so that you are aware what you have done, just like it looks in a question paper. And once you're done, just raise your hand or write down in chat, you're done. But everybody will get equal time 5 minutes from now. Whatever you think is acceptable, okay? No rules there. You're free to make your questions. Just that it should have one correct answer. And three options in total. Two should be incorrect. Take your time. It's easy. Don't rush. You have enough time. And once you're done, raise your hand or let me know you're done.
I'm done, sir. Victor Tango Papa Alfa Romeo.
All right. Guys, right now in the quiz, you need to give me those questions for which you have answer based upon our class notes and whatever we have discussed, okay? So you have to follow the task without any assistance from me. Any other questions that you need me to help you with, I'll help you, but not in the quiz, of course. So questions like how long is a flight plan valid for? We have not covered it in the class, so we cannot include that in the quiz. Correct? So we cannot. But this sure you will get in your notes that I'll share with you all. So Danshu, before the quiz, I cannot tell you if they are right or wrong. So you just go with understanding whether we had discussed this in the class or not. If we had, then great. And once you're done, you can share your questions on WhatsApp with me. And we only have one last minute before we start. Guys, please get ready. All right, get ready, everyone. So Danshu is done, Mukul is done. They have raised your hand, Sachin is done. Okay, good. Okay, guys, are you guys done? Done? Guys, are you guys done? Yes or no?
Yes. Affirm.
All right. Good. So let's go ahead. Let's just do it. Anshul, are you ready with the questions? Are you there with us? You are in Team Air India. Okay. All right. Try to answer with memory. If you cannot answer with memory, you are free to use your notes. All right. No internet searches allowed. Don't do that. Only your notes right now. So the first question will be asked by, of course, Team Air India. Okay. And you can choose to come up and say, sir, my first question. I'm Jeet and I am my first question. I'm asking my first question. You can take lead. All right. I'm not going to take names now, but you will only get 15 seconds to ask the question. All right. And the same thing will be the other team will only get 15 seconds to answer. And remember, you have to give a correct answer and you'll only get one chance and to choose only one option. You cannot say that, okay, Sachin will say option A, Mukul will say option B and Harshit will say option C. So you cannot do that because one of you all will be right. Correct? So only if you're sure that you should raise your hand and then you should give your answer. And that will be right or wrong. Then other student will not be able to get to guess. in the team. Okay. And if you don't answer in 15 seconds, the other team will get a point. You will not get a point. All right. So every question will help you get points. If 6E can answer, 6E will get points. If 6E cannot answer, then AI will get points. All right. So let's start. Question number one. I'm starting the timer. And Air India, go ahead with question. We have only five questions. Five questions from here, five questions from there. So choose your questions wisely. If it is repeated, use your second question or third question. Anima, get set, go. Air India, start.
So may I, Victor Tango Papa Alfa Romeo?
Please, please, go ahead.
Yes. What is a flight plan and what is it used for?
What are the options?
Sir, I need a definition for this one. So no options for this.
No. You have to keep the definition in the option. Option A, option B, option C. And they have to choose the correct definition.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Next question, Air India. It is okay. First couple of questions we'll understand. So, yeah. Air India, come on. A question with options. This was a right question. It should have had three definitions, one of which would have been correct in options and two would have been incorrect. Okay, we need options also. Yeah, Air India, first question.
Unless requested by the ATC, which item number or numbers are not necessary to fill?
Unless requested by ATC. All right, good.
Option
item
A.
Item number 19.
Wait. Let him give the options.
Option A is item 10. Option B is 18. And C is 11.
A, B, C. Okay. Your time starts now. Indigo, just one person will give the correct answer. Think and then go ahead. Anima, guess it, go. Is it option A, option B, or option C?
Item 11.
Item number 11.
Item number 11.
Which is the option, A, B, or C?
They're saying C.
They are saying C.
But it's 18.
Which is the correct option?
B.
Wrong. Come on, guys. Abhipriti, you had already given the answer before the options, but then when he gave the options, you all chose to give an incorrect answer. And understand, first you need to tell me the option number. That's how you will answer. So you have to listen to the question carefully. If you want, you can ask the person to repeat the question again. You can say again question and the person will say the question again. You can write it down, write the options and then choose the correct answer. So what is the question again? Air India? Was it Sudhanshu?
Unless requested. Cool. No.
Who had asked the question? Jeet?
Me, Jeet.
Please, I'll write it on the screen. Unless requested by ATC, which item?
Number or numbers are not necessary to fill.
Which items are not necessary to fill? I like how you said number or numbers. Very good. Not necessary. N-E-C-A-S. Avera. To fill.
Fill.
Option A.
Item 10.
10. Option B.
B. 18.
18. Option C.
11.
11. So, okay, this is tricky. So what is the correct answer from your point of view?
B, 18.
Okay. What is item number? Okay. So I think you made a mistake in the question. All right. Let's hear it from iFly, that is Indigo. Why did you give me answer C, Indigo? Justify your answer quickly. Because it is incorrect from the examiner point of view. Examiner says it is option number Bravo.
Because there's a confusion question. Since it seems like there can be other options. So in other information, such as EET time and passenger or something else special. So option can be filled, but since the question is asked, unless it is required to ATC ask for the question. So in that case, item 19 is the correct answer.
But yesterday from the notes, it was item 18 onwards, it's not necessary to fill to file unless requested by the ATC, which is item 18 as well as the supplementary info, which is item 19.
Okay.
Sir, I think from after item number 18. So after 18, so from 19 is the item number which will be you should not fill unless it is advised by ATC.
It's item 18 onwards, so it's item 18 and 19.
Okay, good. All right. I will correct a confusion, guys. I just want to understand, Indigo, why did you say item 11 in your answer?
Because, sir, item number 18 and item number 10 is equipment and other information. So, item number 11, we don't know what it is. So either option A and option B cannot be there. So I thought option C would be the correct answer.
Does item 11 even exist?
No, that was the point.
Okay. All right.
I don't know, but I thought A and B.
Good. Anybody wants to share anything else? Mukul, Sudhanshu, Pavni, Anshul, Harshit. Okay. So good. Good. This is very good. Interesting. The actual answer is option D and item number 19. All right. So, Jeet, let me correct myself. Up to 18 is mandatory. After 18, 19 is subject to request from ATC only. 19 is supplementary information. Okay. As per the question that you made, 18 is, according to your understanding, 18 was right, but we need to rectify it. 18 onwards, forget that sentence. 19, just use 19. Okay, 19, right. Supplementary information. No, it is okay. This is how we learn and correct our mistakes. You did the right thing with what you understood. So it happens in communication. Okay, I understand, and you're not at fault. Maybe I think I should have chosen better words in explaining, because the same words mean different things to different people. Like Abhipreeti is saying onwards means after 18, whatever she understood, and you thought from 18. You both are right in your own places. The actual thing is up to 18, you're mandatory. It is mandatory for you to fill. 19 onwards, it means supplementary information is subject to request from ATC. All right, everyone. So in this case, when you don't know what fits the answer because the answer is not there in the option, then you can consider the question has a misprint or something. In the examination, it could happen. If that happens, you will always get a mark. Mostly, you should ideally get a mark. We as examiners, we need to give that one mark to the student, provided the student does not attempt that answer. Okay, that is the rule we follow in colleges. On your computer-aided system, you will lose a mark if you don't mark it. So you have to mark something. In this case, if you're choosing Charlie as an answer, because Charlie is not an option, so you're thinking the right thing, but still it will not get you a mark because options don't match. All right, so you need to stick to your correct answer, saying, okay, sir, we know it is 19, but it is not there in the option. You can discuss that also, and you can not answer this until the question is fixed, and then you will answer it. So collectively, I think it was a very good exercise, very good first, a second question, of course. First didn't have options, but Jeet, it is 19. So if you had to change your options, how would you change your options?
I would put it item A, 19, item B, B would be item 8.
And Charlie would be item 11, right? Yeah. I really liked how you used item 11 to confuse. And I'm very happy that people are aware that item 11 doesn't exist. So ideally, it was, apart from the little confusion because of, you know, miscommunication, it was a very well attempted this. But what to do when it comes to marks? Here, now we see that the correct answer is alpha. Okay, answer is alpha. So we will have to discount this question. So we will have a room for extra question. So please be ready with your standby question. All right. I really liked it, but nobody can get a mark because the question was not wrong. So either you, both of you all get one mark or you don't get any mark. It is one and the same. All right. Now the question goes to 6A. Please go ahead. 15 seconds to start asking your question. And Air India, you can ask them to repeat the question and options if you're writing it. And then you will get, once the question is done, you'll get 15 seconds to answer. Only one person will answer and that to correct answer. So think and answer. Go ahead. Indigo, anybody can go first. Your time has started. Sir, 15 seconds. You don't have to ask. Just go ahead.
Okay, sir. What is pre-fill in flight plan? Option number A is filing time. Option B, originator. Option C, both A and B.
Can you repeat the question? Can you repeat the question for me?
What is pre-filled in flight plan?
What is pre-filled? Okay. Pre-filled in flight plan. Okay. Only when I say answer time starts now that you should answer, Jeet, okay? I like how you knew the answer, but wait till I say go ahead because I have to start the timer. Option A is filing time. Option B is?
Originator.
And option C is both 1 and 2. Both A and B. So your time starts both now. Air India, start. Anyone? Correct answer.
Both A and B, Charlie.
All right. Good. We have an answer. Option C. Indigo, is it correct?
According to my knowledge, it is originator. Filing time is the time which we file the flight plan. So we have to write that. But originator is already pre-filled because the time we take the flight plan, it is already filled in. From where we take the flight plan.
Okay, so Indigo is saying the correct answer is bravo. Now, anybody wants to take an objection from Air India? Please support your teammate. He tried his best to give a correct answer. Nobody could. We were running. Do you stand by with his answer? He could be correct, okay? Indigo could be wrong. I'm not saying Indigo is right. This is the whole point of making you make your own questions.
Sir, I think what is his name?
His name is Jeet.
Yeah, I think Jeet is correct, sir. Okay. I don't know, I feel it.
Do you have evidence?
No, sir. Actually, I just felt it.
All right. Okay. Whatever you feel in the exam should only be based upon the knowledge that you have. And the way I teach, I believe I'll make you reach a point where you'll completely know what the right answer is. But for that, you need to study a lot. So if you have studied a lot and you know if he's correct, so we have to still check the facts. So, okay, thanks for supporting your teammate. How about others? Where is the team? Okay, so Danshu, what do you think? Anshul and Dwij. Dwij, share your inputs. Be a part of it.
The answer would be option A and B, the Charlie.
Even you think it is Charlie? Okay, good.
Yes.
Now, Indigo, do you want to support your teammate or do you think the other people are right, because your teammate is saying it's Charlie. What do you think? Is she right or wrong? Is the question right or wrong? Not about her anymore. Mukul, Harshit, Sachin. I'm waiting, guys. No response from Indigo. Can you guys not hear me? How do you read, guys?
Read you 5 Victor and also that.
Mukul and Harshit,
I heard confusion.
Yeah.
Explain the question, sir, once.
Question will be explained to you by your teammate only. Please go ahead with the question. Harshit, what's your input? I cannot hear you. Come on, guys, respond. Why are you quiet? Please talk now. We cannot, we have to make it quick. Quick is fun.
I think it's Victor Tango, Mike and Yako.
Uh-huh.
I think question itself is a confusion. Whether the flight plan is filed for individual flight or repetitive flight. So it can be... So it can be either filed before or changes can be made. So another filing. So from where I see option A, B, it's a confusion. So it can be both.
Okay. Abhipriti, can you explain the question to Sachin once? He was asking. Once, final. Then I'll share my inputs and I'll tell you who is right, who is wrong.
What is pre-filled on flight plan? Like the operator or the pilot don't have to fill what is already printed on the flight plan. So the options are filing time, originator, or both A and B.
Sachin, did you understand the question? Can you share your inputs now quickly?
Yes, sir. I think option will be C, sir, both A and B.
Okay, good. All right. So the simple way to remember, unless you guys can prove me otherwise, and you're always welcome to correct me if I'm wrong. I'm only a human. I can also make mistakes. But whenever you're proving that I am wrong or anyone else, you need to have proof. Let's see. This is the text. This is the reference. This is what is mentioned. I think you made a mistake in speaking or writing something. This is the ideal way to do it. Okay. The key to understand what is pre-filled and what is not is to see what is grayed out and what is white in the flight plan. Over here, if we see the filing time is grayed out, so you cannot fill it. Probably it's automatically filled. So in that case, I think the correct option will be C and not Bravo. But the trick here is that if the examiner is choosing originator in the master sheet, then in the exam, you will not get a mark if you choose Charlie. That is how DGCA papers are, because their options are very confusing. And they go with the most appropriate answer. So you need to be very careful and think about thrice in confusing questions like these before answering. Right now, based upon what I had thought, I think answer is Charlie, because that area is grayed out, nothing else. That is the only connection with which I will say that, okay, filing time and originator is pre-filled. probably filing time is automatically filled. But what about those flight plans which you fill like this manually? So in that, you will not get filing time ready because you have just got a printout. In that printout, maybe you will not have anything pre-filled and you will have to fill everything, even addresses, all right, even originator. But if you're submitting an electronic flight plan, which is the case almost everywhere, then that part will be pre-filled, depending upon from where it is originating. And maybe the filing time will come in when you submit it. That's when the filing time will go to the ATC, because everything is online, right? That's why it is not mentioned here, because this is pre-submission or pre-filing. Once he will submit it, the filing time will be recorded and sent. This is my understanding. So, Abhipreeti, what do you think? Can we go with Charlie as the correct answer so far? Or do you want to stick to Bravo? I cannot hear you. You're on mute. Guys, do we have a connection? Can you guys hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Y'all just heard the explanation, right? Abhipreeti, I asked you a question. Do you think we can go with C, Charlie, or we will still stick to Bravo?
Yes, sir. Charlie is the correct option then, I think. Because I thought there is a blank space for filling time. So we have to write.
Your logic is correct. Your logic is correct. I understand. But we need to focus on the grayed out areas and white areas. And that is a grayed out area, nothing else. Okay, so I think we will...
Option C is correct,
but we will not do assessment on this question because even Air India got one chance for a question that had a little misunderstanding, although the options were not there. But if you had to get a point, you would have got a point on Charlie. So correct answer given by almost everyone. And I'm sure everybody understood what the confusion was. Whoever thinks you have made a mistake, don't feel bad, okay? We all are here to make mistakes and learn. Please don't feel embarrassed also. Just be very happy that you are able to make such important and difficult questions to understand, which are obviously teaching us so much about the level of exams. And I'm very happy to see the first two questions are so good. Even the first question asked by Pauni was very good. If she would have had the definitions ready, it would have been a classic confusing question because she would have played with a few keywords here and there to give us three different options. All right. Going good. Correct answer is Charlie, according to me also. But if we want, we can put the asterisk and we can do some further research on it in free time and see. Okay. We can always do that. Great. Now, guys, we will not delay it. We are on time, but let's see how it goes. Air India, go ahead quickly with your question. You have 15 seconds.
Yes, sir. What is the format of a flight plan?
Options?
ICAO document 4488. Option A, which is Alpha, and Bravo is ICAO document 4444.
An option, Charlie.
And option Charlie is on.
Sorry.
ICAO document 4433.
Sir, what is the question?
Can you repeat the question?
Yeah, please repeat the question.
What is the format of a flight plan?
What is the format of flight plan? Option A, ICAO DOC 4488. Option B, ICAO DOC 4444. Option C, ICAO DOC 4433. And your time starts now. Indigo, time is running out.
It's option B, ICAO DOC 4444.
Is it correct, Air India?
Yes, sir.
Amazing. Amazing. You would have missed your 15-second window, okay? You gave the answer in the last 2 seconds. Very good. Come on, we have finally scoring points. Yeah, you want to share something?
Yeah, so the question it is, what is the format? But I think the question should be what it follows.
No, it is correct. It is correct. I mean, your question is not definitely related to your answer, but it is in a way related to your answer. You get a format of your flight plan in ICAO DOC 4444. Simple. You will not be spoon-fed anything in the examination. And this is a classic example of not being spoon-fed.
Okay.
The good thing is that only one document we have studied so far, but in examination, they will give you multiple documents which you have already studied. Okay. But the answer is correct. Format of flight plan, you will get it in ICAO document 4444. Such questions come in the examination. So I think it was a good question. But others, come on, guys. You should not miss your 15-second window. Okay, Mukul, very good. You saved your team, got 1 mark. And Pawni, good attempt at giving a simple yet confusing question. Very good. So time for Indigo to ask second question. So finally, Air India, Indigo gets 1 point. And thanks to Mukul. So great. Your time to ask your question starts now. Quickly go ahead, Indigo. I fly.
I think they asked the question on the chat.
No, this question was asked by Air India. I want I fly to ask a question now. On the chat. Okay, sorry. On the chat. Okay, I'm sorry. So Harshit has asked us a question. I'm going to read it out to you guys. Which symbol will be used for IFR VFR flight? Option A, Yankee. Oh, so Jeet, read it out for your teammate. Mukul or Harshit? Harshit cannot read. Sachin, read out the question for your teammate quickly from the chat.
Which symbol will be used for IFR VFR flight? Option A, Y, B, Z, C, I.
The time starts now.
Assuming it's IFR first, then VFR, alpha.
Okay, Harshit and Team Indigo, is it correct?
It's correct.
Awesome. Anybody wants to object? IFR first and then VFR. The code for flight rules is Yankee. And that is a correct answer. It is a very good question. I believe only students whom I teach know this answer, to be honest. But I don't know about other people. But majority have not seen anybody know this unless I teach them. So remember this, guys. This will be a USP when you go out. And if people know, then great. If people don't know, then you should be like, wow, we know something more than others. Air India, good. Jeet, you said the answer, right?
Yes.
Jeet, very nice of you to say why you gave me the answer, but you just give me the answer. Later on, you can say why you gave it. But here you just need to submit because it's like you're in the exam and you're thinking in your head, I like that. But just give the option first. But yeah, it is correct. Any way you choose. Option A, very nice. Answer is A, which is correct. Yeah, Pawni, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. I want to give the explanation. I want to explicit why it is.
Sure, you can go ahead. Go.
Yes, sir. You have said you have repeated it very multiple times, and I remember that. IFR to VFR, it comes Yankee. Then if it is VFR to IFR, it's Zulu, which had been said by you.
Correct. And I think you have answered one of the upcoming questions also. The only reason I was not discussing Zulu is because I thought somebody will ask it. So if anybody has made that question, then please change it before you say it, because we already know the answer to that. Pawni, you are right. Thanks for sharing. And anybody has any objection, please let me know. Otherwise, the scores are settled. We only have three more questions to go. Quickly, let's get it done. And Air India, please ask your next question. So Sudhanshu, Anshul, Dwij, you guys should first try to ask a question. If nobody is asking, give 5 seconds.
Then
you can go ahead. Who's this?
Sir, this is Anshul.
Yeah, Anshul, please go ahead.
Yes. A fresh flight plan has to be formed if a flight is delayed for more than option A, 30 minutes, option B, 60 minutes, option C, 90 minutes, option D, 120 minutes.
Now, this question, Anshul, we have not discussed in lecture 1 or 2. So we cannot ask this question.
Affirm, sir. Sorry, I was not there in lecture 1.
Yeah, you have to go through the recordings. That's the reason I have shared the emails with you. No problem. Please go through them. If you have any other question, please ask. Oh, guys, you are running out of time. It is a very good question, but we have to wait about... you have to wait before I teach you all those. So please, hold your horses. Air India.
So, radio communication comes under which item number? So the option A is a 13, option B is a 10, option C is 17.
Just repeat the question once again.
Yeah, radio communication comes under which item number? So the option A is item number 13, option B is item number 10, and option C is item number 17.
Your time starts now. I fly. Just say option number, think about it. The time has started.
Option Bravo.
Item number 10.
Item 10.
Bravo. Who said first Bravo?
Victor Tango, Mike India Echo.
Okay. Is it correct, Air India?
Yes, sir. It is correct, sir.
Wonderful. Anybody wants to object? Wonderful. Very good. Abhipriti, very good. You also gave the correct answer after Mukul. Good, but good. Very good. It was instantaneous, basically. No problem there. Great. Anybody has an objection with the question?
No, sir.
Great. Now, who's going to ask the question? It's going to be iFly, right? iFly, please ask your question. iFly is the call sign for Indigo. Go ahead, you only have 15 seconds.
So the question is, if any changes is bought about a subsequent clearance, what is it termed to? Is it RPL? It is FPL, sorry, FP flight plan, a flight plan. Or I will repeat the options. Option A, RPL, a repetitive flight plan, or RF. So then it is fight flight plan or current flight plan.
Sure, I know.
Repeat your question again.
So if any changes is occurred in what changes occurred? By subsequent clearance, what is this term to?
It's a current flight plan, if including changes. It's
option number.
It's Charlie, sir.
Is it correct? I fly.
Yes. Yes.
Very good. But wait for me to start the timer before answering, okay? Wait, when I say your time starts now to answer, that's when you have to answer, all right? But is it correct? It is correct. Anybody wants to object? Wonderful. It was a well thought question. I would have not thought about this question, but it was good. And current flight plan is that flight plan if any changes occur due to subsequent clearances. If no changes occur, then it's a filed flight plan. And we already know what is a repetitive flight plan. Minimum number of 10 flights on same days of consecutive weeks or 10 consecutive days. Simple as that. Very good. So Pawni gave us the answer. Jeet, do you want to share something about this?
No, like it was perfectly well answered.
Good. I like teamwork. Very nice. Pawni, one. Very good. Going strong, guys. Let's quickly get done with the next question. Air India. When I'll say your time starts now to answer, that's when you answer, okay? So Air India, please ask your question.
Yes, sir. What is endurance? Option A, it's maximum time the aircraft hold with available fuel.
Uh-huh. Option B and option C?
Option B is maximum speed the aircraft with available fuel.
And next option?
Option C is the maximum distance it covers with available fuel.
So your time to answer... Yeah, please. Repetition is required.
Can you repeat option A? Option A, please.
Option A is maximum time the aircrafts hold with available fuel.
Is the question clear? Your answer, time starts now. I fly.
Option A.
Option A.
Who said the answer first? Please end it with
the tango mic and dare.
Yeah, good. Is it correct, Air India?
Yes, sir, it's perfect.
It's perfect. Very good. I'm very happy that you remember this about endurance. It is a very important thing when you will be solving sums related to time to PNR, distance to PNR, and so on. So, Mukul again. Mukul is on a spree, destroying everyone. Hat trick of three answers. Although you're doing it for team, but Abhipreeti, be quick in giving the answer. Don't be scared of giving a wrong answer. And Harshit, at least when you're trying to give an answer, please give an answer. Sachin, please give an answer. If it is wrong, it's okay. What if 15 seconds are over and these two don't answer? Then you lose a mark. And great. Well done. Good question. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 4 of iFly. Who's going now? Okay, 15 seconds will get over if you won't ask a question. Likke to rakha hai na sabne question. Everybody has written it down, right? Just ask. I fly. What? You want to lose a point right now? Not asking a question?
So I will go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. If we are taking an IFR flight, it's an IFR, what is the ETA for that? The option is the time at which aircraft lands the runway. Option B, estimated time at which aircraft reaches the gate. Option C, estimated time at which aircraft reaches a reference point from where it starts approach and with an instrument.
Is the question clear? You want to repeat? Anyone?
So may I answer that question?
Yeah, your time starts. Wait, your time starts now. Yeah, go ahead.
So, time at which it is estimated that the aircraft will arrive over the designated flight.
But that option is not there. The option is Alpha, Bravo, Charlie. Option is time of landing. Option Bravo is time of parking on the gate. And option Charlie is reference when the aircraft reaches the reference point from where it will begin an instrument approach. These are the three options, A, B, and C. The question will only be with Pawnee. No, only Pawnee will answer because he started first. Hold on.
Yes, sir.
Focus on the option.
By reference to...
Okay, which option?
Can you repeat? It's reference something which have been said. No.
So option A is time of landing. Option A is time of landing. Option B is time reaching on the gate. And option C is reference point, time at which the plane reaches a reference point from where instrument approach is initiated.
Yes, sir. Option C.
Good.
I mean, Charlie.
Okay. Is it correct? I fly?
Yes.
Okay. See, here you have to focus on what the options are, not what you have learned. Obviously, what you have learned and what you see in the options has to connect with each other. But you have to focus on the question and the options. All right? Your options can change for a similar sounding question in the examination. Yeah. Sudhanshu and Jeet, you had to say and share something. Please go ahead.
No, sir, it is well answered. The estimated that the aircraft will arrive over the designated point by the reference of navigation aid. So, yeah, the option Charlie. Yeah, it is well answered.
Charlie, correct. iFly, are you satisfied with the answer or do you want to not give them a point because earlier their answer, although I know it was correct, but the right words of the option were not used. But it meant the same thing. But I don't want to be biased. Although we have got the answer correctly when we asked her to read the answer again and options again. What do you think? Was the answer correct or wrong as an examiner?
Sir, I think it is correct because the main aim is to find the correct answer and to learn from it. So,
you think it is correct?
Yeah.
What about Mukul?
Yes, sir. It's correct.
Correct? I feel the same. But the examiner can say, you can say, no, sir, it was incorrect. She didn't give me the right option. You can say that. Okay? Don't feel shy. Nothing like that. We have to be competitive and legit because examiners are very stubborn. If they've set a wrong paper, they will assess you on the wrong paper only. Then it becomes tricky for the student. Great. So, Pawnee again, good. Sudhanshu, Anshul is gone. Dwij is gone. Sudhanshu and Anshul, please try to give answers because only two people are answering in your team. And iFly, please, others also step up. Okay, it's becoming a one-man show or a one-girl, one-woman show. It is okay, I don't mind, as long as your team is winning. But please, everybody take an input quickly and try to answer first. So, Air India gets another point and the answer was correct. Very good. Last two questions to go. Please give something difficult. We are on a tally so far. We want a winner. So Air India, please ask your question. And your time for questions starts now. You're running out of time and the other team will get a point.
While entering the route on a flight plan, we use the word direct to signify what. And the options are from one VOR to another VOR. Option B, from one aerodrome to another aerodrome. And option C is from a significant point to another significant point.
Please repeat the question and options once again.
While entering the room on a flight plan, we use the term direct to signify what? Option A, traveling from one VOR to another VOR. Option B, from one aerodrome to another aerodrome. And option C is from a significant point to another significant point.
Your time to answer starts now. I fly, go ahead with your answer. Ten seconds left.
Sir, I think answer will be C.
Okay, we have an answer. Good, you saved your team at least. You gave them a fighting chance. Very good, Sachin. Option C is the submission. Air India, please tell us if it's right or wrong.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. Okay, anybody wants to share their inputs on this? Nobody knew the answer. It was a tricky question. Jeet thought a lot in making this question, and I'm very proud, Jeet. Very nice. All these questions are very nice, guys. You have put in a lot of thought in making the question. I can see that. Good. So although this information is not directly given, but this information is given in the example of the flight plan. And okay, this is an important question also that you will see in your notes that I'll share with you. DCT is there, when to use it, where to use it. And there are multiple correct answers to this. But although we have not seen it in detail, so I'm not expecting you all to remember. But as per the examiner, significant to significant point is correct. And luckily, the answer is also correct. So, okay, you get a point. But let's just check. Jeet, why do you think you gave us this question? And where did you get this from?
I just like popped in my head when I was thinking about the flight plan.
Was it based upon our sessions or just out of the blue? Cannot hear you, Jeet.
It just popped in my head like as when I started thinking about the flight plan to make different questions from what I had written.
Okay, from what you had written. Good. That's what I wanted to know, from what you had written. Or maybe it's from outside or something that you know otherwise. Or is it from the notes and what you have studied in these two sessions? Okay. Okay. Anybody else wants to discuss something about it? Because you guys seem clueless apart from Sachin, who seemed correct about the answer. How about others from iFly? Do you realize if it is a correct answer, your teammate given a correct answer? And how about others from AI? Do you think it is a correct answer? You think your team member is right to give a good one mark to iFly? Or do you think the question answer could be aerodrome to aerodrome or VOR to VOR? See, we see the use of the word DCT here on the route. All right. So the route that this plane is going to follow is uniform Romeo 14. Then they will go to a VOR STU. Anything that you see in three letters is a VOR. It's a navigation aid. So VOR Sierra Tango uniform, or you can take the name of the aerodrome associated with it. It could be Stuttgart, however you call it. And then you go to route uniform Golf 1. Then you go to another VOR, Whiskey Oscar Delta. I think I don't remember the name of the place, but I'll give you a solution to this flight plan, okay, in your notes, so that you can actually see what is the name of which aerodrome and all. Then from there, you fly direct to this VOR OCK. So right now, if this person has used DC or a PIC Yandel, if Yandel here has used DCT, so his DCT is from VOR to VOR in this section. Okay. Now, if we see this question, the question has, question also says VOR to VOR. It also says aerodrome to aerodrome. It also says significant point to significant point. All right. From where I see, all three answers are correct. Because wherever you don't have a route connecting one VOR to another, you can fly direct. Understand, flying direct means you don't have a route connecting to those two places. So you choose to fly direct, taking a bearing from the destination aerodrome, saying, tell me the direction which I can use to fly to you. It can be aerodrome to aerodrome also. Certain aerodromes are not connected to each other, but they're so close together that you want to fly direct. And a significant point to significant point. What is a significant point? It is any point on your route where you make some changes. So it could be that you have two waypoints which are not connected by a route, and you can fly from one significant point to another using direct route. As per this, the most appropriate answer could be significant point to significant point, because any significant point could be a VOR also, it could be an aerodrome also en route, or it could be a waypoint also. It could be anything. So this is my understanding and my explanation. And I think you all guys are on the right track. But when you get the notes where you see DCT notes, read it thoroughly and understand it on a deeper level. So far, everything looks very good to me. And I'm very happy to see what you guys are doing. Sachin, well done. Others were stumped. And Jeet, I think you were not expecting Sachin. You would have won if Sachin would have not answered in the last minute, last second, I mean. Yeah. So you are on the right track in making your questions. And Sachin, well done. Saving one mark for your team. Superb job. So competition is getting tough. Three more questions to go. And remember this, guys. This is a very good example. Most appropriate answer is actually significant point to significant point. It is okay. If we see otherwise in the notes, we'll happily correct ourselves. But this question can come and this could be the answer. Any three could be the answer. Most appropriate is Charlie only. So iFly, please ask your question. Your time starts now. Arshu, do you want me to go with your question? Yeah, fine. We have a question from Harshit. Somebody from iFly, check out chat. And no, it's a direct message, so I'll have to read it. The question for Air India is this. In ICAO location designator, okay, everybody write it down. In ICAO location designator, and iFly, you also think about an answer in your head, okay? Although it is given to you by your teammate. In ICAO location designator for Delhi is VIDP, Victor India Delta Papa. What does India signify in this? When I say ready to answer, that's when you will answer. Keep the answer in your heads and be ready to answer. Option A, it is used for airports in India. Option B symbolizes the FIR region for Delhi and the neighboring regions. And option Charlie, it signifies Delhi Aerodrome only. This is the question. And your answer time starts now.
Bravo, bravo.
Okay, we have a submission. End with a call sign. Who gave me the answer?
Victor Tango Juliet Sierra Bravo.
Great. iFly, is it correct? I fly. Is it correct or incorrect? Okay. Anybody wants to object? Anybody wants to give an explanation? The second letter over here, India. Yeah, yeah, Pawni, go ahead.
So V stands for AFSRA, which means
Aeronautical Flight Service Routing Area. Okay.
Yes. The I stands for FIR and D and P stands for airport or aerodrome.
Very good. According to that, I is for FIR and that is the correct answer. Anybody has an objection? Speak now. No objection. Then great. Everybody agrees to it. So shall I give a mark? I fly. Air India gets a mark, right?
Affirms.
Very good. Very good question. All right. Final two questions, decisive questions. Try to make it difficult. Try to make it so difficult that the answer given will be incorrect by the opposite team. Okay. But it should be from what we have studied. At least make it so difficult that they take more than 15 seconds to answer. Each one of you. Air India, question number 6. I'll give you a couple of minutes to think about that question. Whoever is ready to go first will go first. The only thing that you cannot do right now is discuss between each other. So you have to have that mutual understanding right now. Unlike other team games where, you know, we can talk to each other before we send one person to ask the question. Maybe you can chat each other on direct saying, guys, I'm going to go first or something. I don't know if you can do that or not as participant. But yeah, I hope you keep your questions ready. It should be difficult, everyone. And Air India, your time starts now to ask the question. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. In item 16, how many alternate aerodromes consist?
Item 16 consists how many alternate options, please?
Aerodrome.
Yeah.
Alpha option A is 1. Option B is 3 and option C is 2.
All right. The time to answer by iFly starts now.
Option C.
Option C. 2.
Air India, is it correct?
Option B, sir.
Okay, Sachin, I'm happy. I'm not happy. I mean, you gave the answer later. So Mukul gave the first answer. Let's see if his answer is correct or not. Option C. Air India, is it correct?
Yes, sir. Option C is correct. It's 2.
Very good. Anybody wants to object? Sachin, in the flight plan, if you see, you have 2 alternates. Check. Alternate aerodrome and second alternate. Okay, wait. I cannot share. I have not shared the screen. Sorry. Wait. Yeah. But when we do flight planning, I have discussed it once that you have 3 alternates that you can plan with. Departure alternate, en route alternate, and destination alternate. According to that, Sachin, you are right. There can be 3 alternates. But in your flight plan, you will only put any of those 2 alternates. That is how it is. The first priority alternate and the second priority alternate. So as per the question, it is 2. But if they don't ask you a question about the flight plan, but they talk about flight planning. Okay. Right now, we are only talking about ICAO flight plan. We're not talking about flight planning. When they talk about flight planning, then you can say at least 3 alternates can be decided. But on a flight plan, only 2 go. And which, see, you can see 16, alternate aerodrome 1. 1 is not written, just alternate aerodrome is written. Echo Golf, Bravo, Bravo. And second alternate aerodrome is left flank because it's a short flight. They only have one alternate here. Everybody thorough with this? I hope you can see the screen. See item 16. Item 16 is destination aerodrome, total estimated elapsed time, alternate aerodrome, and second alternate aerodrome. So, Air India, should I give 1 point to Indigo? They get it. I'm not getting a response, but I'm sure they get it. Last question and decisive question. Let's see. Air India, please think and answer in time. You'll only get 15 seconds. But if you want them to repeat the question, you can ask them to repeat the question. And the best way is to read the question slowly so that you don't have to ask. But if you ask too much, too slowly, then they will think about the answer and be ready to give. So that being said, iFly, question number 6, please go ahead. Your time starts. Your time starts now. iFly, time is running out. iFly question. Yeah, Vipriti, go ahead.
Aircraft registration falls under which item number? Option A, item number 18, 18. Option B, item number 19, 19. Option C, item number 7.
And your time to answer starts now. Air India, go ahead. 1, 2, 3, go.
Alpha.
And who gave me the answer?
Victor Tango, Julius Sierra Bravo.
Okay, that was quick. Very nice way to perform. Okay, iFly, is it correct? iFly, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
You don't sound too happy. Okay. What? I thought you were not happy to see they gave the correct answer. Anybody has any objection?
No, I'm happy.
No, I'm just did not get a very quick reply. So I'm just, you know, just thinking if, you know, it's scores are tied, right? Check this out. Other information, 18. The first thing filled in here is registration marking for this particular aircraft. It is GBGJG. Okay.
Actually, sir, I can read you too.
Oh, no problem. Okay. Everybody, registration marking, you will find in the other information section, which is item number 1818. So answer Alpha is correct. It was a good question, not a direct question. Very nice. And Jeet, you gave one more answer. Can you tell me who gave me the answer for question number 5 from you, Air India? No, from was it you, Pavni, who gave me the answer for question number 5? No, it was not Pavni. Pavni then gave us the explanation. Was it you, Jeet, who gave me the answer for question number 5?
That's my question. Yeah, it was me, FIR region.
Who gave me the answer, FIR region? Was it Mukul?
Me, Victor Tango, Julius Sierra Bravo.
You gave the answer, right? Others, iFly, do you remember who gave the answer?
Radio 2.
Yeah, question number 5. Question number 5, asked to Air India, do you remember who gave me the answer? Was it Jeet? I'm asking iFly. Erinda, you tell me which of your teammates gave me the answer. I also think it's Jeet, but I want to verify. Guys, can you hear me?
Radio 2, sir.
How do you read? Guys, how do
you?
Lagging, sir.
So read you three Pukto Tango Papas from here.
Okay, I understand, guys. Let's just bear with each other. Maybe some network issue here. Just let me know when it improves, okay? All stations, all 8 stations, Mumbai control, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How do you read? All stations.
You 5
control. Everyone, can you read me on 5? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Roger. Victor Tango Papa Alpha Romeo Roger. How about others?
Affirm.
Radio 5, sir.
Wonderful. So my only question is, last question that I'm asking right now is, Air India, from your team, who gave me the answer for question number 5?
It was me, Julius Fiera Bravo.
Yeah, I want others to tell me. I know, even I think it was you, but others might be aware because they did not give the answer. So team Air India, who gave me the answer for question number 5?
Sir, it's Jeet, and I gave the explanation of that question.
Okay, fine. Thank you for clarifying. What about Sudhanshu? Anshul? Right. It was Jeet, right?
Yes, sir. It was Jeet, sir.
Okay, good. Thank you. I'm not doubting you, Jeet. I just wanted everybody to be aware about it. I'm not sure if they are or they are not. So I just asked. So final, we get a good score here. Which is very good, with the start of a little error in the questions from Air India and iFly. In the end, we saw that 10, actually we discussed 12 questions and everybody was actually correct about the answers. And although, you know, initially there was a few confusion, but we understood so much about it. So I'm very happy to see that you have 5 and 5. We have performers here, wherein and one more thing, guys. iFly, last answer. Who gave me the answer for last question from iFly? This item 16 consists how many alternates? I think Mukul gave me the answer. Was it Mukul? Okay, great, good performance, Mukul. You gave 4 answers first. Abhipreeti, you just gave every answer after Mukul. It could be because of the network issue also. We are not comparing anyone, but it is good to keep individual scores also. And Sachin, very good, you answered one more. Harshit, you have network issues. You cannot talk, I understand, but you need to do something about it. It is okay if you have a little background noise. At least when you are talking, you can unmute and talk. All right. So please get comfortable with that. You have to, because I need to hear you in between. I know you're trying. And that is good. Abhipreeti, I've heard you give all correct answers. Amazing. Harshit, I've not seen you give any answers, so I don't know, but your questions were very good. Mukul, well done. You have taken your team to victory. Sachin, very well done. Your performance there would have cost 1 mark if you would have not performed. You saved 1 mark because it was in the last second. And amazing. And talking about Air India, Jeet, well done. Questions and answer both. Pawni, amazing job. Sudhanshu, I remember you have asked a question. Your answers, you were thinking, taking your time, and you didn't want to go wrong. So you let them answer and they answered. Overall, good teamwork. But I would like to see you give answers. Even if you're wrong, it's okay. All right, like Sachin gave one answer in the end and it was wrong, but he was like, sir, I think this is the answer, wherein I understood why he gave the answer, because he knew that there are 3 alternates. Somewhere he remembers that. So whatever wrong answer you'll give, somewhere you'll be right about it. It's just that the answer and the question understanding is somewhere up and down, which I'll rectify for you. So the more you speak, whether right or wrong, the better it will be for you. And Anshul, we really need you to fix, attend the lectures and fix both. Please go through the recordings and come back. Don't miss, you're getting a golden opportunity to do everything on a fast track from zero. It will help you revise, help you understand more. It will take away your time for self-study completely because you'll revise along with the lectures. So don't take it for granted. All right, good. So far the scores are tied. I was hoping to get a winner, but I think both the teams are winner right now. So well done. Winners are Air India and iFly. It really means that the future of Indian aviation is in good hands because both the teams have performed really well. And I'm really very happy. Congratulations. I wish I could play music, dance and celebrate, but any music I make and upload, they will take my video down due to copyright issues. So I'm not going to play. And yeah, well done. Anybody has any question, please ask. And one by one, Air India, Team Air India, please share your experience. Did you have fun? Did you learn? Two questions.
Affirm. Victor Tango Papa Affirm.
Jeet. Sudhanshu. Anshul.
Roger, that's so. I haven't had this kind of quiz competition before, so it was completely new for me. So yeah, I learned something from today. Yeah, it was all a good thing for me.
Thank you for sharing. Jeet, Anshul?
It was really interactive and informative to go through the chapter all again in such a different manner.
Did you have fun? Did you learn something?
Yeah, sure. Definitely.
Anshul? No response. iFly, Team iFly. Mukul.
So I learned where I was getting confused and I get to know better. So that was a great experience.
You're a top performer, huh? Top performer is so modest.
I was letting somebody answer. If nobody answers, I go ahead.
It is good. Looking after each other is good. Jeet is also the top performer. Pavani is also a top performer. Everyone is a top performer because I'll share my feedback later. Abhipreeti, please share.
Yes, sir. I learned a lot from this exercise. And there were many tricky questions. So learn how to tackle them. And I had fun also.
Thank you. Sachin?
Sir, actually, once I get, you know, sir, I had this, and I don't know the solve question, sir. In this season, I had learned something new.
Very good. Very good. Learning something new every day is important. Thank you for your feedback. Harshit, can you speak something?
Am I audible, sir?
Very, very clear. Loud and clear, like Jeet says. Jeet, please replace your loud and clear with 5. Just say radio 5, okay?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you are readable 5.
Yes, sir. I got to learn a lot of new things. This is something very new to me. And yeah, definitely, I learned a lot from today's class.
For you and Sachin, did you guys have fun?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Archit, you're saying something,
Archit. In between, there is a background noise, so I cannot answer it. So I was just asking questions.
No, that was a good thing. You did not give up. You put your questions in chat.
And yes, sir.
That is good. But always try to talk, even though there is background noise when you're required to talk. Don't worry about it. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Sachin, did you have fun? You didn't say.
Yes, sir, it's very fun.
Okay.
In that last question is, I'm thinking just, sir, I had guessed the only answer, sir. Ajit question. I don't know that question, but I had guessed it.
Very good. It was a good guess. I hope now you know the answer.
Yes, sir. I know.
Very good. All right, guys. So see, from my experience, I can share a few things with y'all, and I want y'all to take it seriously, okay? That it was amazing to see how well y'all participated, okay? And sometimes I think whether I'm just, you know, wasting my students' time by doing something or the other. I ask that question to myself. And I don't really want to, you know, spend unnecessary time with y'all, because we can always use it to cover a few points, all right? But then again, what really matters to me is whether you guys are understanding, enjoying, learning, and growing, and working hard, all right? With seeing how you guys have done so much today, and everyone had taken a good part in it, everyone, I won't say people who have not asked many questions did not play a part, or people who did not give answers did not play a part. It really means something, you know, it really means that you guys are on the right track, all right? And this is all it takes from your side, being sincere with what you're doing. Right now, if you're studying for your papers, just be sincere with it. And I'll tell you something, it is very difficult to find students who are sincere. There are students who will pay and who want to pass, but they are not sincere with studies. And it becomes very difficult for me to teach them because they don't attend lectures. They don't give time. They don't do as I tell them to do. And I was very afraid because I've just started with you guys. Right? So I was very afraid to see whether you guys will participate or not. That tells me whether you're interested or not, or you're just doing for the heck of, you know, just because you have to do it. You don't know why you're doing it. But with the way you guys have done it, I'm so happy that you all are connected together, because it shows me a sense of equality in terms of all of y'all. It might be that you're just attending the first session or not, but somewhere that you have stuck so long, like we saw one student leave because he had not attended early lectures and all. So I'm just not saying it personally, but in that case, he will not study as much as you will study. And that is very understood. With experience, I can say that. Okay. This is the reason I said after some time, I'll just lock the sessions for whoever is there. All right. So that, you know, we know that our target is for you guys to achieve the desired result. And when you do something like this, what you did today, when you get into the shoes of the examiner, you become one step ahead in clearing your exams. Earlier, I used to teach these skills in the end of navigation studies. But I realized that at that point, the pressure of the exams is so much on the students that they stop taking things inside and they start worrying more. So I realized that whatever these things that I have to teach should happen initially, and then we should proceed with our syllabus so that, you know, you will always remember this, and in between you will keep doing it. And obviously we'll not always get a chance to have a quiz session like this, but we will try to do more fun stuff in which we learn, not sacrificing our learning of concepts. So it should not be like we're just learning flight plan for 2 weeks. We have to do a lot in 2 weeks. And along with that, we have to focus on the quality, and quality takes time. All right, it takes time. So although we have just started with sessions, which we stretch up to 1.5 hours, or maybe a little less than 2 hours, the ideal time should be 3-hour sessions with a little break in between. All right, that will give us good enough time to cover topics that we start. Now, ideally, I wanted to finish flight plan in one session. All right, because we still have to do the validity of the flight plans, filing of the flight plans, and then in planning, the syllabus says that you have to do plotting also, charting also, calculation of airspeed, this and that, all the jobs that a flight dispatcher does. But those questions don't come much in the examination. From the examination point of view, a few things are necessary, but you never know what will be asked in the exam because it's a part of your syllabus. So today, I really wanted to discuss the syllabus with you guys, but what I'll do is I'll share the soft copy of the syllabus with you guys, so that you are in sync with all that we have to cover. And our target will be to cover 80% out of the syllabus, because a few things are not important. I'll mark those things. But it doesn't mean you should not study and go. Anything can happen in the examination. You should only focus if this do or die in your examination. So you prepare. And do or die should be now, not during the time of your exams when you have not prepared enough. If I'm not prepared enough, then don't do and die. Say, it's okay, I'll give my best and there'll always be next attempt. But not now. Not right now, it should be do or die. And the reason I've just started with navigation for people who are doing other papers with me also is because we start with navigation and get comfortable and we start mastering navigation because other subjects are very easy compared to navigation. So I'm very happy with what you're doing. If you have any requests or queries, drop me a message. Any negative feedback, please put it across. We are going to get into second gear of our training where we'll start learning more, a little fast, and with a little longer lectures, maybe from next Monday onwards. I will be very interested in having a weekend lecture with you. Will it be on a Saturday or a Sunday? I'll let you know by today evening. If there's anything, please let me know. All right. And remember, we have just got started. And it's going to be amazing if you stick till the end. If you don't stick till the end, then guys, I cannot guarantee anything. But if you stick till the end, then I guarantee that you will learn more than any other student from your age group and everything else, which will help you clear your exams ASAP, along with getting a knowledge which will really help you crack your interviews in future when you are acting as a fresher CPL or going for scholarships for flying or anything else. All right. So that being said, if you have anything to say, please speak. I'll give you a minute to get started. If not, we'll end the session for today. All right. So have a happy Friday, guys. Happy lunchtime. Take a nap or something. I'm going to see you in the next class. And I'll share the schedule shortly with you all. Until then, if I have anything, let me know. Well done. You all are winners. You have proved it with your scores. Congratulations, Team Air India. Congratulations, Team iFly. Let's see who can outdo each other in upcoming sessions. When we do more topics, when we start number games, calculations, we will see that we'll have more difficult questions, more complicated questions, and your ability to make complicated questions will make your ability to solve complicated questions even better. See you, everyone. Very happy to have you all as my students. I'll see you all until the next class. Go through the recording whenever you want. Uploads will be done and links will be shared with you. See you, everyone. Bye.